guys, welcome to my channel. I'm thinking instead of trying to do all one look in all one video, maybe I should split them up. Maybe starting with the eyebrows, show you how I do my eyebrows, and maybe the skin, and then make another video and do the final look. If you're interested, just keep watching. So I'm just going to start out with brows. I'm actually going to take my Lancome booster. It looks like this. This is actually for your lashes, but you can find products that you can multi-use for different things. So I'm just going to run this through my brows, and I'm literally just brushing them up, because when you brush them up, it is going to give you a lift, and that's what we want. This is probably going to be very different for you if you haven't done this, but why not give it a try? You might actually like it. What I do is I just take my finger and I push up just on the ends. Next step is to take Precisely from Benefit. It's my favorite product. This is the shade 3.5. I'm just going to start here and do hair-like strokes in an upward motion. You're not actually filling the whole brow in, you're just given a few darker lines, if you will. This is for that thick, bushy brow effect. And I love it. All right, so now I'm just gonna take 2.5, which is a little bit liner, and I'm just gonna do the same thing, like just little strokes, light pressure. That product will pretty much grab the color from the pencil. Now my favorite part, I'm gonna take the Gimme Brow, shade 3. Brush them up just like I did before with the eyelash primer. To me, the bushy brows just make you look a little bit younger. That's all. That's why I love it. Next step, I'm going to use a little bit of my favorite, which is the Peter Thomas Roth. Cannot find it anywhere. It's discontinued, and most good products are. So this is the Skin to Die For Mineral and Matte CC Cream. I had to find it on Poshmark. I'm just gonna take a little bit on the back of my hand, and I'm going to mix it with the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow. Now you can add, let's say, you can add even a cream highlighter. This one has SPF in it. This is the Blur Luminosity Rose. And it looks like that. So it's literally like mixing in your favorite products. I've already prepped my skin. I put on sunscreen. Put on serums from The Ordinary, and now I'm just dabbing this along. I mean, you can take your brush and grab it from your hand, but I would rather do it this way. All right, so I'm just gonna take my Real Techniques brush. This is the 402. Just gonna start blending it in. Are you guys ready to decorate for Christmas? I think I'm gonna do it this weekend. Time is flying. here, I'm blending out every little spot. Take it on the ears as well. You can take it down the neck, but I have on self-tanner and it's developing right now, so I'm just gonna skip that step today. Alrighty, so now I'm gonna take my Nudies Matte, a cream blush, and this is the shade Sunset Strip. It's really pretty. I'm just gonna bring it up. I just realized I didn't even paint my fingernails well. Literally just in my band tee, just kind of chilling out today. I'm gonna be painting my bookshelves white. I'm gonna take my Real Techniques Beauty Blender and go over that. And now I'm gonna use my favorite concealer as usual. I'm just gonna put a few dots here. Also take your brush to blend it out, but I usually like to use my finger. And I'm taking it all the way up to my lower lid. And that inner corner. Mainly just focusing it in this area. Right here. If you get carried away with your blush, you can just, you know, take your brush and tap it around. Like so. Alright. Taking my beauty blender, I'm just gonna tap it a few times. And then I'm gonna take my translucent powder. This is Ciate London. And it smells just like coconut. I love it. I like to use my BH brush. No number. But it looks like this. Tap it. This is going to set it. And also, it's going to keep your mascara from running all up under there. Which is a disaster. I tend to get a little bit oily, so I like to take it around my nose. Now I'm going to take my Laura Geller Baked Body Frosting. You can literally put this anywhere. And I'm using my Tapered Face F25, my Sigma brush. I'm just going to tap it around, mainly on the outer here. And then bring it in. This is so pretty. I love this. I don't get to use it very often because I don't really tan, you know, all the time. So, bring it down the nose. All right, and I'm going to take my Legrachetti Beauty Mist. This smells amazing. Taking my beauty blender. This is optional. You don't have to do this. So I picked up these new Milani lip pencils. These are great. They're creamy. They feel so good. This is the color. It's called Spice. So I'm just going to put Spice on the outer. I'm going to take my other one. Okay, so I had to go get my other one. This is the shade Nude 03. But first I'm going to take Spice. I have this white line that goes around, and that's what I'm filling in. I think Milani is my favorite lip product because they're just creamy. I am overlining slightly. Alrighty, so now I'm gonna take my nude and I'm gonna put it all over. It's not wanting to stick because I have on a lip balm. I'm actually gonna take my cream blush and I'm gonna use it as a lip for today. It is beautiful. Tip, if you want to, you can also take what you have on your lip and kind of put it as your blush. I'm actually gonna dip into this Beach Matte Sunset Dip, Sunset Deep, from Laura Geller, and I'm just gonna set the cream product I have underneath right on the edges. Like I said, I've got on the tan, and it's gonna. My body's gonna be darker than my face. I'm just gonna blend that out a little bit better. Should I contour my nose today or should I just leave it as is? And honestly, I love a good contour. So I think I am gonna go in with my LA Girl. And I'm just gonna put it on the back of my hand, just like this. Just enough to do my nose. I don't need a ton. And I'm gonna take my e.l.f. brush and kind of dip in it. I want my nose to appear longer and narrow. Just making a natural shadow. And it does look crazy at first. But after you blended it, it looks pretty good. Some people like to draw the line here. I mean, you can. It's not necessary. You can take a little bit of concealer on the side. Just gonna take my beauty blender and kind of tap it. And I'm gonna take my bronzer again. So now I'm taking the brush that I used to put on my translucent powder with, and I'm just gonna blend it out. Alright, now I'm just going to take my Ofra highlighter. This is in the shade Rodeo Drive. I'm just going to put my finger in it and kind of tap it. And up here as well. I like to use my BH brush that looks like this, 140. Just going to take that highlight right here. Take the brush over it as well. You can even put this on your ears. We are very glowy today. Okay guys, so that is the final look for prepping. If you want to see the eye look I do with this, just click on the next video. I appreciate you watching and I will see you guys on the next one.